That was Harry. I mean, he was the griot of our community from a visual standpoint.
One thing about Harry was he's a people person. I always said he could talk to a rattlesnake because that was his style. Harry knew everybody. He loved what he was doing.
I think he trained a generation of people who understood the importance of chronicling the history of the city of Milwaukee.
Hello, I'm Joanne Williams. Before his passing in the fall of 2011, Harry Kemp spent about 40 years photographing the people, places, and things in Milwaukee. He had a special eye towards Milwaukee's African-American community. We'd like to share his legacy with you.
Photographer is really only as good as his subject.
Mm-hmm.
And over time, you have a certain skill of visualizing and knowing something when you see it.
Sure.
Without that, you just pass by.
For more than four decades, Harry Kemp was the visual griot of Milwaukee's African-American community. But his interest in photography began much earlier in his life.
I had a friend. His name was Raymond Patterson. Lived right next door to me when I was maybe 10.
Mm-hmm.
He took me to his basement and showed me how to develop film. And I had never seen that done, and just the mechanics of it was so fascinating. You know, you took the celluloid film and you put it in a camera and you took somebody's picture, and then you took the film downstairs, and the image is like creating a child or something.
Mm-hmm.
There's before your very eyes, my creation. Yes! So,
wow.
That I said, this is magic.
Okay.
So I wanted to create that too.
He started when he was 12. He got his first camera. He got a little brownie. Okay? And he probably messed around with it. He really didn't know what he wanted to do, had not even thought of that.
Born in Racine in 1933, Harry Kemp and his family of two brothers and three sisters grew up in Milwaukee. He graduated from Lincoln High School at 17 and joined the Air Force. He remembers growing up in a community where people looked out for each other. In the 1940s and 50s, Milwaukee's African-American population was small. Harry grew up in a family of notable Milwaukeeans. His mother, Marie, and stepfather, Lincoln Gaines, were active in community events and taught Harry and his siblings to be of value to their community.
I was helped raised by a group that formed the first a black YMCA in Milwaukee.
Sure.
That was called the Booker T. Washington YMCA. Yes. A lot of people might be connected a little bit with Robert Starnes.
Sure.
And Mrs. Frances Starnes.
Mm-hmm.
They all came out of the Booker T. Washington
mm-hmm.
YMCA. They got us kids off the street, washed us off, brushed us up, gave them a sense of pride
sure.
and responsibility, and gave us some orders about how we should behave. The things we talked about that should be imbued by the public schools. This is what you do. This is how you talk. This is how you dress. These are things you don't do, right? And helped us recognize the importance of respect,
mm-hmm.
both for others and in the process by ourselves.
I learned get involved, be aware of your surroundings, be aware of what people are doing, and certainly any time you can make a difference, it's your responsibility to do so.
And those lessons became a vital part of Harry's work.
My whole life has been acquiring a legacy based on my relationship with people, primarily older people, although younger
sure.
people too, but primarily people. As I grew up, my first legacy in the sense of acquiring my knowledge was my parents,
mm-hmm.
you know, what they did and how they did it, how they were admired for what they did. It was important to me. It helped me recognize the authenticity who a person really is. It's not something you think about in the abstract and come up with something, but something you experience and share both intellectually and physically with another human being.
Harry's interest in photography blossomed after he left the service.
When he was discharged, honorable discharge, he went to college in Waco, Texas, all right? Through the college, there was something driving him back to pick up that camera. So then he decided he would take some classes, okay? Then he taught as well. But it just became a permanent fixture.
Harry loved Milwaukee. There were hundreds of community events over the years that the mainstream media ignored. Harry Kemp and his camera were there. It seemed as if he was always there. He was everywhere.
He always seemed to know things that were going on and where people were. And like you said, he always showed up just about every place. Did that surprise you?
Yeah. I mean, sometimes you wonder how he knows about everything that's going on. You know, even internally, a lot of times we'll have to call our staff and say, hey, you know, we got this thing going on tomorrow and nobody's aware of it. Well, Harry was always aware of it. So, and not just Brewers events, you know, you go to other community events around Milwaukee and some of the suburbs and you see Harry there.
From the beauty contests to the lodge meetings, from the private birthday parties to the community organizing sessions, Harry felt it was important to document them all, to show the reality of African-American life in Milwaukee. He was more than a photographer. He was truly a journalist.
He grew with Milwaukee. So as the African-American people grew, he happened to be there and captured the important moments in Milwaukee. He can tell many tales. He had a lot of interesting stories. And I'm sorry now that I didn't tape them.
Harry was very community orientated. And I think what he wants to show everybody in his pictures is our progression from the 1960s up until the day he died. I think it's just about, and it's not just black, okay? It's Milwaukee, okay? This town. Yeah, he's black, but all these social events and all these events, the artists that came to Milwaukee, the politicians that served here in our town, he covered all of that. So it's about Milwaukee. It's not just the black community. And I wanted to stress that. It came from a black perspective, but it was still Milwaukee.
Before taking pictures for newspapers, Harry was the after-hours photographer in Milwaukee's black restaurants, taverns, and social gatherings. That's where he began using a Polaroid camera. The pictures were instant, and there were no negatives to make copies.
At first, he worked for an organization called Triple O. It was a community organization back in the day, so to speak. But they lost their federal funding. So he had to supplement his income, and that's how he would do it. He had a Polaroid camera, and he would go around to the different nightclubs and hotspots around town, and he would take pictures of people that were couples, singles, whatever, and then he would charge them. The funny thing is, he would charge me the same as he charged them. And I'm saying, wait a minute, I'm your brother. Why are you charging me?
Did you pay?
He said, no, he'd look at me and he said, okay, give me $5.
Harry Kemp picked up a camera professionally in 1969. He began as a photographer for the Milwaukee Courier and the Milwaukee Times, then the Milwaukee Community Journal. After more than a dozen years on staff, he struck out on his own as a freelance photographer, selling pictures to all those papers. Harry was a man of pictures, but also a man of words. He read a lot and learned a lot along the way, and when he put the camera down, he had plenty to say.
Come together. We're still a family. We're still a social family.
He was very articulate. A lot of people don't know that Harry is very articulate because they really didn't, all they saw was the cameraman. You know, they never sat down and actually had a conversation with him. But he had a mind like a steel trap as far as memory is concerned and current events, community events. He knew just about everything he needed to know to do the job that he did.
He also became the official photographer of the Milwaukee Brewers in 2005 and recorded the events on the field and off of the baseball team and its fans. To make a living as a freelancer, he had to shoot and shoot and shoot pictures.
16 times 2, possibly 3. Yeah, 16, might as well say times 3. And then we have a few at the house yet.
Man.
Yes. I'd say easily he has a million photos. Easy.
He had to be at every event. He had to cover every news conference. And he got around town in a way that kept him close to the community. Most of the time, he rode the bus.
He would take the bus. Sometimes he would have his own car. But he was always out there and taking pictures. And sometimes I'd be out on assignment, think, I should have called Harry, but Harry would be there already. So that was covered. So I'd tell Harry, you want to get a couple of pictures for me? He says, no problem. And he would have them.
He always had that great sense of humor, a very outgoing personality. And I can remember as mayor more than once traveling around town and seeing him at some point and actually having my security pull over and pick him up and say, hey, Harry, I bet you we're going to the same place. Hop in. Or we'll give you a ride to where you're headed. Because he, more than just about anybody in this city for the last half century, lived the city. And I say that as a compliment.
Over the years, Kemp's pictures covered politicians, celebrities, news events, entertainment, local community events, and sports. Since he took so many pictures for so many years, you see the same faces as they live their lives in Milwaukee. When he became a photographer for newspapers, he kept this in mind: show the reality of the situation, but be respectful and don't aim the camera at someone just to find their flaws.
People, politicians, or business owners, what always present the picture respectfully. They were always thought of and projected far as the camera is concerned, and giving their picture to the newspaper. It's very, their respect first, always.
Harry Kemp was at my wedding. Harry Kemp took pictures with Matabel Woods at my wedding, which was a little over 20 years ago, and I knew him before that, but that will always be the day I remember him the most, that he came to my wedding and had a nice picture in the community paper with my wife and I as newlyweds.
Harry seemed to get every picture he aimed for, but there was one picture that he missed. His sister Yvonne says he was in Washington, D.C. on a very cold January 20th, 2009 for a very special event.
The morning of the inauguration, Harry went into this little cafe to warm up and have a cup of coffee.
This is in Washington?
Yes. All right. So Harry said all of a sudden the Secret Service came in, a big limousine pulled out in front, and there comes Barack, and he says, hello, my name is Barack Obama. I'm being inaugurated today. And got him a cup of coffee. And everybody went ballistic.
Did Harry get the picture?
I don't I think that happened too fast for him that time, because he was all bundled up and he was freezing.
His younger sister Joanne said Harry had a special sense of humor. It made you think about the joke. But when he was out shooting pictures, he was all about business.
Harry had a sense of humor that was kind of funny but dry at the same time, but always had some kind of message in there. And that used to intrigue me all the time. I'd say to myself, okay, that's a joke, but it means something. You know, it was one of those kind of things. So I enjoyed the last 10 years of Harry's life, and I learned a lot. I used to see Harry out, and he'd always say, hey, baby sis. And then, of course, he wanted to take pictures. And I'd say, how much, Harry? He'd say, 10 bucks. I said, Harry, I'm your sister. I'm your baby sister. He said, well, okay, today is $10, baby sis. He said, but you're so beautiful and gorgeous. He was pretty good schmoozer. He'd schmooze you up real good.
Kemp lived in downtown Milwaukee, easy to get on the bus, and close to his second home, the Mykonos Cafe at Van Buren and State. Every morning, he sat at the table behind Betty Kinziger. He had his breakfast. Over the years, they shared conversations about everything from raising children to photography.
Harry used to come over here and read the paper every day, you know, and he was so, you could talk to him about anything. He knew about so many subjects. You know, he was a very interesting man, very nice, kind, gentle man.
The folks who became Harry's second family at Mykonos also knew that he had a skill that set him apart from other people. Apart from some other journalists, he listened.
He was a great friend, a great listener, and full of knowledge, full of life.
What do you think you learned from him?
I have learned so many things. He was a great listener, but he was also giving me just daily advice about life, about people. I learned so much from him.
He could talk to anybody and just sit down, just walk into a room and just start talking to people and getting an idea of what they think. And then he would come back and tell me about, well, this is what I heard, and or this is what I think based on what I've seen or heard on the community. And we would sometimes take the tenor of our editorials from that and go and proceed.
Like I say, he was a very kind, gentle man, you know, very easy to, and he was a very good listener. And a lot of people aren't very good listeners. You know what I mean?
As he lined people up for that group shot that would go in a newspaper, he was listening to their conversations and comments. He was listening to the speeches given and the policies announced by Milwaukee's decision makers. And over the years, he developed an intimate knowledge of the city.
People think he was just a guy who took pictures. He wasn't. A lot of the photos were people, he would just line up and shoot the photo. But there was history in those photos that he took. There were people who were part of history, or the history of the community, who impacted on government, on the schools, on the arts. And so it was just more than just, shooting photos of people lined up. You know, what he took was history.
I traveled with Harry. When I say traveled with him, oftentimes I joke when people run for office and I see them for 4 or 5 months and I talk about getting on the merry-go-round, and they get on the merry-go-round for 4 or 5 months while they're a candidate, and then they win or lose and I never see them again. But Harry was on that merry-go-round with me for well over 25 years because we would be at so many different events in the city because he chronicled this city, and he was really the storyteller of Milwaukee through his photography for decades.
He would come in and we would look over the photos that he had taken during the past week since he was last in the office. And it wasn't just, getting photos from him, getting caption information. It was also, talk about issues. Talk about what's going to be in that week's newspaper. Issues that we may want to, look into, trying to cover in the newspaper. He was always had a lot of ideas and suggestions about how we can make the community journal better. And we tried to take, some of that to heart. Mostly we just talk about the community, what needs to be done to rectify the problems in the community. And the people in the politics and sports, and we talked about a wide range of things. And it was always really something to look forward to for me when he came in, because talking, I got a lot of wisdom from him and from the things that he had seen and what he observed. And he's kind of like the postman, rain, sleet, snow. He was out there getting photos,
He combined his pictures and knowledge of what was going on in Milwaukee's black communities in the Community Journal's Question of the Week, which he asked and photographed.
He would ask him provocative questions sometimes. We had to be careful of some questions, but for the most part, they were just stuff that would deal with the issues of the day in the black community of Milwaukee.
In the 1960s, Harry taught photography and later became a mentor for others who wanted to work in communications fields.
What did I learn from him? I learned how to make do with what you have. That's what I learned. I mean, along with the consistency and along with being determined to be that you are, and he was a photographer. He was always there in every location, despite transportation, despite weather, despite conditions. He was always there. And he did it as a freelancer with very few resources. And that's the difference, whereas we worked for a television station with many resources, he was still able to do it. And then to look at his work for what he had is, I'm impressed.
When I got into broadcasting some 30 years ago, Harry was right there on the scene, because if there was something happening in the community, he was there. He was there. And he was an icon.
The most fun he probably had was taking pictures for the Milwaukee Brewers. A lifelong sports fan, he saw stories and histories on the field and in the stands.
I think Harry's specialty was showing the Brewers in the community. Whenever we did an event away from Miller Park, which we've really tried to focus on in the last half dozen years or so, Harry was always there. We never even had to call him to say, hey, are you going to be at this? He would always see our press releases. I'd see Harry at least once or twice a homestand, usually more out here at the ballpark. He was always shooting pregame ceremonies, game action. But then I'd see him out in the community as well. When we'd do events in the community, he was always the first there and the last to leave. So we'd see Harry everywhere. Well, Harry was a guy that is part of the fabric of the Brewers. He touched the lives of many people here at the Brewers.
3 years ago, his sister Yvonne joined her brother in the freelance photography business. She is carrying on his tradition and helping to preserve his legacy. In the news business, when you're busy doing your job, going after the next event or story, you sometimes forget to look back at the job you have done. When Harry began to look back, he realized he needed help organizing all the pictures he had taken over all those years.
He pulled the chair out. And he has a nice little snack table.
He called in his sister Yvonne to begin sorting and cataloging all the pictures and negatives. They began to think about putting together a book of his work. After a stroke that put him in the hospital for a while, he asked Yvonne to pick up a camera and begin shooting with him, to learn the business and to pass Kemp Photography on to her.
And while he was in there, he must have did some thinking and told me, he said, I'm going to pull you out of the office, and I got some people that I want you to meet. And that's how it got started. Harry had his own method, which he did pass down to me, because most people say that I know the first time my picture went in on the front page and they put Harry's name on it by mistake, I knew I had done a great job.
And not just Brewers events, you know, you go to other community events around Milwaukee and some of the suburbs, and you see Harry there. And now you see Yvonne there as well. And it's really a neat thing.
Who's going to take his place?
Yvonne. She told me that, you know, I can shoot photos, but I can't replace him. And that's true. You can't replace Harry. He's one of a kind.
He loved what he was doing. In fact, The camera took over Harry's life. I will say the reason why Harry never married is because of the camera. He put the camera first. And you know, we women, we want to be first too. But Harry's first love and last love was his camera.